News Hour with Deborah Hope.
Good afternoon. Coming up, Christy Yamaguchi. She's in Vancouver for a competition this weekend, and she'll join us live from the rink at GM Place later in the broadcast. And then there's Judy Garland. She's going to do a number for us. She's just one of the women in female impersonator Chris Peterson's act. A short break now, but don't go away, because when we come back, a special performance from one of Canada's leading female impersonators. I'd like to introduce a very special guest to the Noon News Hour now, Judy Garland.
Hello, Deborah. How are you, dear?
Thank you so much for coming in today. It's been a while since you've done anything.
Well, that's right. You know, you don't get out very much when you're dead, you know. But that's all right.
Well, while you're here, I was wondering if you would do us the pleasure of doing a number for us.
Well, I'd love to do one for you. Do I just go down here now?
Why don't you
thank you so much. This is a little song, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to sing to you now. It's by Mr. Harold Arlen, and it's for all the friends of Dorothy viewing today. Upon a star and wake up where those clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops way above those chimney tops. That's where Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much.
Wonderful.
Thank you, Deborah, darling. Oh, and Liza, get Mommy a drink, please. Thank you so much.
No drinks. This is a family show.
Oh, I'm sorry. It is early in the morning. How about just juice, then?
Juice would be fabulous. We'll work on that.
Thank you so much.
Chris Peterson.
Hi, Deborah.
Oh, this is really amazing. It's always very entertaining when you come and visit us.
Thanks.
Thank you for coming. Now, you are performing tomorrow night.
At the Commodore Ballroom.
Yes. And
o'clock.
You're charging $25 a ticket
yes,
for this.
Yes, but it's a great show, though. You have to understand, there's, you know, wigs and costumes cost a lot of money to entertain the public, so... Yeah, I don't think a ticket price is that high, you know.
Don't.
Well, the Phantom's 90, and we're much prettier.
Yes, you've got a good point there. So how long have you been doing this now?
Well, 15 years, and
15
7 years.
Years
professionally, yes.
You're based in Toronto.
Yes.
And you do theater as well as female impersonation.
A couple of years I've been doing theater. I've been doing drag in theater, but, you know, I'm still doing, you know, what I do best, so...
Now, this has been happening for a long time, of course, the drag queen phenomenon, but do you think it's getting more accepted by the mainstream population?
Well, I think with films like Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, and Tu Wong Fu, certainly it's becoming more mainstream. And with RuPaul, you know, getting a MAC makeup contract, you know, I think that the public is more aware of drag. Mm-hmm. And of course, if you watch any of the trash television shows, they certainly have us on for ratings sweeps weeks, you know, quite often. So, but you know, I think it's getting a very good pitch, which is great, and a very positive pitch towards it all. And you know, it's a form of entertainment that's been around for a while. So why not enjoy it?
Well, I want to thank you for coming in. I know it's early in the day for you. You normally don't get up till about noon.
Oh yeah, well, they dig me up every once in a while for these things. So I don't know what time it is.
I just have to ask you this: how long does it take you to get the makeup on?
Well, it's a little more time than real women and less time than the Phantoms.
Thank you, Judy. Chris.
Thank you, Deborah.
And just because it's Friday and you might be in the mood for a little entertainment, we close the show with another female impersonator who is impersonating a woman I'm sure we all know. Have a good weekend. See you Monday.